Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, dipersilakan duduk. Yang berhormat, Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, Menteri Pengajian Tinggi Malaysia. Yang berbahagia, Datuk Profesor Emeritus Dr. Muhammad Zawawi bin Ismail, Pengerusi Lembaga Pengarah University, College University Antarabangsa INTI. Her Excellency, Miss Penny Williams, Australian High Commissioner to Malaysia. Professor John Duffield, Pro-Vice-Chancellor of the University of the West of England and the Executive Dean of the Faculty of Health and Life Science. Mr. Teo Chi Kiong, Business Development Manager for Agilent South Asia Pacific.
Yang berusaha Puan Zita Fahmi, pemangku Ketua Eksekutif Lembaga Akreditasi Negara. Yang berusaha Encik Abdul Karim bin Jaafar, Pengarah Penguatkuasaan dan Inspektorat Sektor Pengurusan Institusi Pengajian Tinggi Swasta. Yang berbahagia Datuk Nordin Muhammad Yatib, Yang di-Pertua Majlis Perbandaran Nilai. Pegawai-pegawai Kementerian Pengajian Tinggi dan Jabatan Pendidikan Negeri Sembilan. Professor Dr. Li Fa'an, President of INTI International University College. Ahli-ahli Lembaga Pengarah INTI Universal Holdings Berhad. Div-div kehormat, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Yang berhormat, izinkan saya meneruskan ucapan saya dalam bahasa Inggeris. On behalf of INTI International University College, I welcome you this afternoon to the launching of INTI International University College's Bachelor Degree Programs. Before we commence, I would like to call upon Mr. Hasib Arif, a second-year Business Administration degree student from Pakistan, to seek blessings for this evening event.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان والأرض وضعها للأنام فيها فاكهة والنخل ذات الأكمام والحب ذو العصف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان خلق الإنسان من صلصال كالفخار وخلق الجان من مارج من نار فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان صدق الله العظيم.
Yang berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, INTI officials and staff, guests and participants, I greet you with the universal greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace and blessings of Almighty God be on all of you. Knowledge is that crucial factor which leads to the advancement of a nation, and today we have gathered here to contribute toward the dissemination of knowledge. We ask Almighty God, the one whom besides there is none, the Lord of the heaven and the earth and everything in between them, from whom we came and to whom we shall return, we ask him to enable us to acquire knowledge in order to dispel ignorance and foster unity among everyone for peace. We ask God to guide us to the straight path. We ask God to bless this gathering and grant us success in every noble endeavor that we may undertake. Amen.
Thank you, Hasib. We will begin today's event with a welcome dance performance from Indonesia entitled Saman. Saman is the most popular dance in Aceh and it has become well known abroad with the name Thousand Hands. It has its origin from the Alas ethnic group and is normally performed to celebrate the birthday of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and other important occasions. Let's put our hands together for INTI International University College students from Indonesia.
Wasn't that a wonderful performance? Yes, at INTI International University College, we get to be mesmerized by the myriad of cultures from all over the world. Let us give the students another round of applause. Now, having enjoyed a cultural experience, we would now like to take you on a journey down memory lane. So, ladies and gentlemen, let us all sit back and enjoy.
A story of an acorn. An acorn with a dream. An acorn which ended up in a jungle, hoping to be as tall as the other trees. The acorn had not the slightest idea of what was to become of it. It was an acorn with a dream. Fighting the bitter cold, struggling through the scorching heat, the acorn strived to stay alive. Stumbling blocks were what lay in front of it.
The campus itself was very small, of course. We don't have much facility. We started on an office floor with 39 students in one of the buildings in the Greenfield area.
Survival seemed bleak, yet the acorn continued hoping.
Busy at Wisma Sibling, which we only occupy initially one and a half floor. And I think there are only maybe some classroom and quite a number of part-time lecturers. All very hardworking.
Many knew not the outcome of the struggle. They had no clue of what the acorn would turn into. And yet, they decided to share in the dream of this acorn. The acorn's strength became their strength. The acorn's dream became their dream.
That was where I first met President Tan. His office was in this very small room. He talked fast and acted even faster. Even in those early years, I had a great admiration for his ability to think way ahead of us ordinary people.
And in 1991, we again moved to the Subang Jaya campus, and there the student population grew leaps and bounds.
Minutes turned to hours. Hours turned to days. Days turned to months. The acorn remained an acorn. Yet, the acorn hoped and hoped and hoped.
Then came a ray of light, spreading warmth, comfort, and insurmountable courage to the acorn. It lit a path for the acorn, a path which the acorn decided to venture into. Little did the acorn know that it was the ray of hope which was lighting the path of opportunity. With a sudden burst of energy, the shell which conformed the ability of the acorn opened. Soon, the first leaf had sprouted. Stumbling blocks turned into stepping stones. Adversities were faced head on.
INTI has prepared us so well that I was granted scholarship, teaching and research assistantship, which helped to finance the studies, living and travel expenses while I was in the States.
I'd like to thank INTI for the great education that you guys have brought to me. I always treasure the great moments and the great experiences I had with it.
As days passed, roots formed, creating a strong foundation for the acorn. Branches started forming and new leaves appeared. The feeble stem started turning into an invincible trunk. Forging new dreams and creating new hopes for the many around it, it grew wider and taller. The wider it grew, the more it could accommodate. The taller it grew, the more prominent it became. fueled by the love and the trust of the people. Where once stood a little dwarf, now stands a formidable giant. Today, it stands hand in hand with the many giants around the world, spreading success in its every wake. Sheltering those who seek refuge and promising them a future, this oak tree stands tall, not merely in the jungle, but in the hearts of the people. And this story shall be told for generations to come. For this is the story of an acorn which became an oak tree.
For your information, the acorn was compiled for the 20th anniversary celebration and was presented at the gala dinner in November 2006. Yang Berhormat, ladies and gentlemen, we are proud to have been able to share with you a little about the history of INTI from its humble beginnings to what we are today. It gives me great pleasure now to call upon Yang Berbahagia Professor Datuk Dr. Muhammad Zawawi, Chairman of the University Board of Directors, INTI International University College, to give his welcome address.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Yang berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, Menteri Pengajian Tinggi Malaysia, Profesor Dr. Lee Faon, President College University Antarabangsa INTI. Sorry, I forget Her Excellency Mrs. Penny Williams, Australian High Commissioner of Malaysia. A special welcome to you, Her Excellency. I believe this is your first visit to Lilai. I hope you will enjoy your special day here. Professor John Duffield, Pro Vice Chancellor and Executive Dean of the Faculty of Health and Life Science, University of West England. Encik Abdul Karim bin Jaafar, Pengarah Pengarkuasaan dan Inspektorat Sektor Pengurusan IPT. Saudara Dr. Zulkifli yang mewakili Ketua Eksekutif LAN. Encik Teo Chi Kiong, Business Development Manager, Agilent, South Asia Pacific. Yang berbahagia Tan Sri Tan Sri, Datuk-Datuk, Datin, wakil media, tuan-tuan yang saya hormati sekalian. Bagi pihak lembaga pengarah universiti, kaki tangan serta para pelajar College University INTI, College University Antarabangsa INTI, saya mengemalukan kunjungan yang berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, Menteri Pengajian Tinggi Malaysia, kampus kali ini. Saya juga mengucapkan setinggi-tinggi penghargaan kepada Yang Berhormat Datuk di atas kesudian untuk melancarkan program ijazah College University Antarabangsa INTI pada hari ini. Ladies and gentlemen, let me begin by extending a warm welcome to Yang Berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, the Minister of Higher Education, Malaysia, who has taken time off his busy schedule to grace our event today. Yang Berhormat, your presence here today makes this occasion a meaningful one, not just for the INTI International University College, but also for the INTI International Education Group. Today's ceremony will leave an indelible imprint in the history of INTI International University College. The year 2006 was a very eventful year for INTI. It celebrated its 20th anniversary of active involvement in the higher education industry. And a major milestone was the elevation of our flagship campus here in Nilai to become University College last September. with the establishment of INTI-International University College, or INTI-UC as we like to be called, the first private university college in the state of Negeri Sembilan. We are able to offer our own full degree programs. INTI has come a long way since its humble beginnings in 1986. INTI College, as you were then known, was set up at a time when Malaysians were looking for options to pursue a foreign degree locally. Being new and relatively unknown, we had to work hard to establish ourselves as serious providers of quality education. Through the years, we gained the respect and trust of reputable universities abroad, and today we collaborate with some of the top universities in Australia, Britain, Canada, New Zealand, and the USA to provide world-class quality education, not only for Malaysians, but also for students from around the world. Today, as INTI-UC embarks on a rebranding campaign with well-focused, well-balanced for a theme, I feel proud that INTI-UC is offering its own degree programs in addition to the 3+0 twinning and other programs offered in collaboration with our partner universities. We are well-focused and well-balanced in that we provide an ideal environment where students can focus on their studies and fulfill their wish for a well-rounded and well-balanced education. Our competent and dedicated lecturers play an enormous role in educating and guiding students to become high achievers, not only academically, but also in other aspects of life to be well-balanced. Local and foreign students enjoy the many facilities that cater to the provisions of an holistic education. Branding obviously is especially important in the recruitment of international students. Although INTI established itself as a brand name in some of the countries, these were mostly in relation to foreign programs. Now that INTI-UC is able to award its own degree programs, it will be able to leverage on the strength of its foreign programs as a jump start. Today's ceremony is a symbol of INTI's journey from beginning to prominence in the education industry, and I'm pleased to be part of this remarkable achievement. In 20 years, INTI has produced and nurtured more than 20,000 young graduates. We have made an impact in enhancing Malaysia's name. We have created educational opportunities for thousands of worthy students through our scholarship programs. And through it all, we have supported the government in realizing the Malaysian aspirations to excel in the areas of human resource, technology, and higher education. INTI International University College takes great pride in its contribution to the progress of education in Malaysia and pledges continuous effort in support of a knowledge-based economy towards prosperity and progress for the nation. Once again, I thank Yang Berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad for his gracious presence at this auspicious occasion and for the support rendered to INTI-UC, and not least to everyone present today for being able to attend this memorable occasion. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dato, for sharing INTI International University College's vision and mission with us. Now, we would like to call upon Professor Lee to give an introduction of INTI International University College. Professor.
Yang Berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, Menteri Pengajian Tinggi Malaysia, Her Excellency Ms. Penny Williams, Australian High Commissioner to Malaysia, Professor John Duffield, Pro Vice Chancellor and Executive Dean of the Faculty of Allied Health Science, the University of West of England. Yang Berusaha, Encik Abdul Karim bin Jaafar, Pengarah Penguatkuasa dan Inspektorat Sektor Pengurusan IPTS. Forgive me, I should have addressed Datuk first. Datuk Professor Zawawi, Chairman of the University Board of Directors. Mr. Teo Chee Kiong, Business Development Manager, Agilent Southeast Asia Pacific. My colleagues from IPTS in Malaysia, Tan Sri Tan Sri, Dato Dato, Datin Datin, Wakil Media, Tuan Tuan dan Puan Puan yang dihormati sekalian. In 1986, when INTI embarked on the journey of providing courses of study for school leavers, little did the founders realize that what started as a small college would one day grow into a university college. The founders were driven by the need to create access to higher education that seeks to develop informed and insightful students who can fit themselves in global situations. INTI has achieved this through the American University program, which has successfully transferred over 10,000 Malaysians to over 200 universities in the United States of America. Our students include those sponsored by Tenaga, Petronas, and Telecom. Just like other students and their parents, these sponsors chose INTI for their scholars precisely because INTI is able to deliver. Similarly, INTI is able to have world-ranking universities on its list of partners because of its credibility in matters that matter most to them. Premised on the same approach of advanced standing and credit transfer, INTI College in 1991 began to work with universities in the United Kingdom, particularly in the field of engineering. The achievements of its diploma graduates in these universities have been singled out by the former Minister of Education, Tan Sri Musa, in the year 2003. He wanted to know whether INTI had any secrets in this matter. To him, an average of about 30% of students scoring first-class honours in the universities such as Nottingham, Manchester, Leeds, Liverpool, Bradford, Hertfordshire and Birmingham is truly amazing. In 1993, INTI began working with the University of Otago in New Zealand. Students were admitted into the final year for degrees in accounting, finance, economics, marketing, and business administration. In 1994, diploma in engineering students were accepted for admission into the third year of the four-year Australian engineering programs in the University of Sydney, University of Queensland, Monash University, University of Adelaide, University of New South Wales, Queensland University of Technology, and RMIT. Many obtained first-class honours. And in 2004, the University of Adelaide reported 37% of INTI students obtained first-class honours. Ladies and gentlemen, the credible performance and achievements of INTI's graduates in highly ranked universities in these countries is a measurable outcome of an INTI education. Back in the 80s, the Ministry of Education then had neither the prescription for operation nor officers to facilitate the growth of IPTS, which were very much left to their own devices. INTI chose to be a competitive IPTS. It placed high priority on systematic development of quality in education management, curriculum development, and teaching. But the same goes, vision without funding is hallucination. So INTI went public in 1996 to raise funds for building facilities and resources. Thus, in 1998, INTI College was able to move to its present purpose-built campus in Nilai. Built and furnished and equipped at a cost of over 150 million ringgit, it has all the facilities that a campus community needs. In addition to lecture theatres, laboratories, resource rooms, sports facilities, INTI International University College has residential facilities for 3,600 students. The campus is fully wired with broadband connectivity of 8 megabits to every room. And continuing to focus on its critical priority areas, a 110,000 square feet learning resource center was built in the year 2002 to house the library. Today, true to its mission of providing quality education, INTI International University College can confidently build and design its university phase based on the reference points provided by the Ministry of Higher Education. Quality assurance has been given the highest priority with the appointment of an Associate Vice President to the post of Teaching and Learning. The main thrust of this office is to develop, implement, and manage a quality assurance system for teaching and learning. INTI University College is justifiably proud of the achievements of its internal quality assurance. All its 3+0 degree transfer programs, and nearly all diploma programs have received accreditation or provisional accreditation. The Quality Assurance Agency of UK, in their report to the University of Hertfordshire and Coventry University on the quality assurance processes of the 3+0 programs, commented very favorably on INTI's high compliance with quality standards. To ensure the development of the culture of excellence, INTI International University College academic staff are encouraged to be involved in research, publication of research articles, and participate in seminars and conferences. INTI International University College began publishing its own journal in 2001. It is now a refereed journal which regularly publishes papers by researchers from other universities in Malaysia, as well as the private sector. Concurrent with research and publications, INTI has also organized 3 international conferences so far. This November, it will be hosting its 4th international conference in Putrajaya. Through the joint efforts of INTI Foundation and the Malaysian Science Academy, INTI International University College hosted public lectures by Nobel laureates, Professor Douglas Osheroff in the year 2004 and Professor C.N. Young in 2006. It also hosted the bestseller author of High Tech, High Touch, Mr. John Nesbitt, in 2003. Since 1991, INTI has given out scholarships amounting to 31.95 million ringgit. If the value of scholarships granted by partner universities to its students through INTI are taken into account, the total scholarship value is about 81.4 million ringgit. All these reflect INTI International University College's commitment in carrying out its corporate social responsibility. This year, it will commence on a research project designed to study the socio-economic impact of the Nipah virus epidemic in neighboring Bukit Pelantok and Sepang. INTI International University College has allocated a sum of 1.6 million ringgit for staff research. The internationalization of INTI International University College started in 1989 when it began enrolling international students from Singapore, Brunei, and Indonesia. By the middle of the 1990s, it had a strong network of recruiters in many countries. By 2003 and 2005, INTI received awards for having the highest enrollment of international students. INTI-UC's other internationalization efforts extend to student exchange with two universities in Europe and two universities in the United States. The curricula of all INTI-UC's degree programs include the development of soft skills and compulsory internship. This internship, which is structured, may be carried out in the United Kingdom if students so wish. This certainly adds another dimension of internationalization of INTI International University College. The rich cultural environment in INTI-UC, with students coming from 51 countries, provides a platform for the development and acquisition of global competence. In particular, INTI-UC students would have had the opportunity to live and study within a little United Nations. Almost half of the elected office bearers of the student government, INTIMA, are international students. Ladies and gentlemen, INTI-UC encourages its students to balance academic pursuit with extramural activities. INTI-UC considers the development of the inner self as a consequence of experiential learning. We have chosen the name well. Taken from the Malay and Sanskrit word, INTI means the essence. In Latin, INTIMUM means the innermost. We have adopted INTIMA to be the name of the student government as they form the core of the student body. INTI International University College, by its name and substance, empowers students so that they become resourceful, independent, adaptive, and innovative. We, in other words, prepare students who will succeed in their careers and in life. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Professor Lee.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera dari majlis majlis, Her Excellency Fanny Williams, Australian High Commissioner to Malaysia, Professor Emeritus Dato Insinyur Dr. Zawi Ismail, Chairman University Board of Directors, Professor Dr. Lee Faon, President INTI International University, Professor John Duffield, Pro Vice Chancellor, University of West England, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. About 2 months ago, Professor Lee Faon visited me in my office with his management team, and during that meeting, I indicated my desire to visit the college, and here I am. 2 months later, in Nilai, and I thank you most graciously for the very warm reception. Those of you with your beautiful national dresses, the entrance of this great hall, I thank you for putting up a very great show. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and indeed, this is one of the benefits of education. The cultural exchanges which you are able to go through in this institution, the friendship and networking you're able to develop in the course of your studies, this is a very important aspect of education. And INTI International University College, with 35% of its student enrollment coming from overseas, I think is one of the premier private colleges in this country. It goes to show that Malaysia boleh, as we can see from the presentation, you started from very humble beginnings and you've come a very long way. You have surmounted so many challenges, you have gone through a few difficult periods in your history of 21 years, but you've succeeded in resolving all the issues and problems which you faced, and at present you are one of the top private colleges in Malaysia. I would like to congratulate you for the success. I have a friend who sends his child to this college, and on the way to this college I gave him a phone call. About 10 minutes before arriving here, I gave him a phone call. I inquired from him how was the experience of his child attending this college. And he was full of praise for this college. And I'm glad that his child obtained a good education in INTI International University College. His son is now in UQ doing engineering in Brisbane. He was here for 2-3 years doing a diploma. I believe now he's in his third year doing an engineering degree in Queensland, in Brisbane. And as Professor Lee pointed out, many of your students not only managed to move on to higher degrees, but also many of them have done extremely well. This is again another proof of your quality, another proof of the outstanding achievement you've achieved in the last few years. And it goes to show that we Malaysians are capable of achieving great success in many areas, and education is certainly one such area. Indeed, despite all the issues and problems raised sometimes by people here and there, but overall I think we've done well. In private education, we have done extremely well. We have been, as you know, pioneers in many areas. We've been one of the pioneers in twinning, one of the pioneers in transfer programs. The variety that we offer in Malaysia, I think, is second to none. There are not many countries in the world which has the kind of system that we have in Malaysia. We have a choice of 3+0, 2+1, a choice of transfer programs. You have all kinds of programs being offered by our universities and university colleges, and indeed we have done extremely well in the last 20 years. But the success of this country, of course, depends on two things. Mainly, one is the policies which we in the government put in place, and secondly, the initiative and the effort of the private sector, people like you in INTI, people with drive, with commitment, with initiative. The government can only set overall directions. The government can only set the broad parameters, general policies, but it's people like you who will drive the process and get us to achieve the best in whatever we do. So we've done well, and this success has been due to the policies we've put in place, the liberal environment we have in this country, not only in education, but also in several other areas. Our commitment to pursue excellence, our commitment to resolve problems and issues, our dedication and commitment to ensure that we facilitate the private sector. And this, of course, has been aided by the drive and commitment on the part of entrepreneurs like what you have in INTI International University College. We have come this far, but we want to move further up the value chain. We want to achieve greater success. We're not satisfied with what we've achieved. We want to do a lot more, and that's why we have to keep on running. That's why we have to keep on moving as fast as we can. For that reason, as Minister responsible for higher education, I'm committed to ensure that we continue to make improvements in enhancing quality. I'm committed to ensure that Malaysia achieves greater success in private education. I'm committed to make sure that Malaysia is recognized as a leader in higher education. I know that this journey is fraught with challenges, but I know that with the cooperation and commitment of everyone, those of us in government and those of you in the private sector, we can together achieve greater success in the years ahead. The focus is now on quality. The focus is now on enhancing the quality of higher education in Malaysia, in public and private universities and colleges. And we have to benchmark against the best in the world. I'm glad to note that you have collaborated with many fine universities throughout the world. I'm glad to note that many of your students have done extremely well, but we have to keep on striving for greater heights. The fact that you've attracted more than about 2,000 of your students coming from overseas, from more than 50 countries, that in itself is one measure of your success. That is one indicator of how successful you have been. The profile, the visibility you have achieved in some of these countries abroad, the network that you have developed among the agents in many of these countries, the standing and reputation which you enjoy in these countries, all these show that you have achieved a lot. All these indicate that you provide education of the highest quality, and I hope that you will continue working hard to achieve the government's objective of turning Malaysia into a hub of educational excellence in this part of the world, and indeed in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, as I said, we've come a long way, but there's a lot more that we have to do. I'm convinced, after having met so many of you, especially those in the private education sector, with the entrepreneurs we have in this country, with the support and cooperation from our friends from overseas, I know that we can make it. And by the year 2010, hopefully we can be even more successful than we are now. 2010 is the timeline, the deadline that I've set for myself to ensure that Malaysia achieve success in higher education, greater success in higher education, that we become recognizable, we become recognized and acknowledged as a hub of excellence in education in this part of the world. And it is a date, a year in which we hope to be able to host 100,000 foreign students from throughout the world. So ladies and gentlemen, some might feel this is a tall order, it is an impossible task, but I know that with the help and cooperation and support from all of you, we will be able to get there by the year 2010. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been around for more than 20 years. Your students come from more than 50 countries. Another indicator of success, I think, is the fact that some of the sponsors in Malaysia have sent their students to your university. This is again another endorsement of your quality, for otherwise they will not be sending the students to your university, and I hope that you continue to attract students from these sponsoring agencies, and given your track record, I know that they will continue to support your university. So ladies and gentlemen, today we are, I understand, going to launch your logo and going to launch some new degree programs. We're going to award some merit scholarships, and as indicated by Professor Zawi and also Professor Lee, you were awarded University College status about a year ago, and let me take this opportunity to formally congratulate you for being awarded the status an award which you deserve. And I wish and hope that you continue to strive for greater achievements and put yourself in the forefront of private education in Malaysia. On that note, and once again, I would like to thank you for hosting me this afternoon. I congratulate all of you students who are here in this hall, especially those of you from overseas. I hope you enjoy your studies in Malaysia. I hope you enjoy your stay in this country. We are doing everything possible to ensure that you spend your most memorable years in this country, whether it is issues you're facing with immigration, with our bureaucracy. We are trying to ensure that your stay in this country is as hassle-free as possible. We're trying to ensure that you enjoy your life and stay in Malaysia. And above all, of course, we hope you get good quality education. We hope that you develop linkages and friendships with locals and those of you from other countries as well. Malaysia is a place where many things happen, and I'm proud once again of the fact that there's so many of you in this university coming from so many countries, and this indeed is one very important dimension of higher education. And I'm pleased that INTI International University College has contributed to the government's objective of making Malaysia a hub of educational excellence. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, I congratulate you for all your success in the last 20 years, and I wish you all the best for the future. And I know I can count on your support and cooperation in ensuring that Malaysia continues to achieve success in the sector of private higher education. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Yang Muhammad Datuk, for your very inspiring speech. The upgrading of status to university college by the Ministry of Higher Education has indeed given new inspiration to the management and staff of INTI International University College to enhance the quality and prestige of higher education for the benefit of all. So without further ado, we invite Yang Berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, accompanied by Datuk Dr. Muhammad Zawawi and Professor Lee, to unveil the INTI International University College's logo, followed by the bachelor degree programs. Thank you, Yang Muhammad Datuk. We will now take you on a video tour of INTI International University College teaching and learning facilities. Mm-hmm. now we'll continue with a short video clip on quality teaching and learning in INTI International University College.
Quality teaching and learning at INTI-UC. At INTI-UC, the key to our success lies in our focus in providing quality teaching and learning. Key activities supporting and promoting quality teaching and learning are diligently implemented, reviewed, and continually improved. Today, we are proud to share our good practices in quality teaching and learning at INTI-UC. These are a 4-day INTI Academic Skills Training Program, which is HRDF PROLIS approved. Training on specific teaching skills. Classroom observation of teaching. Peer observation of teaching. Transformative learning initiated by the Faculty of Engineering and Technology. Teaching and Learning Committee at UC and faculty levels. Conference and seminar on teaching and learning. Centre for Instructional and Technology Support, CITS. Teaching and learning resources. And student evaluation of teaching. To complement our face-to-face teaching, we are proud to introduce you to INTI Online, our learning management system. At the Home Centre page, students can view all the courses in which they are enrolled. Students can access the teaching materials for these courses. Self-assessment tests with feedback are also available to further enhance students' learning. Lecturers can use the online forum discussion facility to encourage students' independent and collaborative learning. In addition, students can consult their lecturers through emails. Other learning facilities available in INTI Online are learning guides from student learning support, chat room, and e-notices. To support quality teaching and learning, the Centre for Instructional and Technology Support, CITS, was established in 2002. It provides training and instructional consultation for lecturers. It is also a resource centre for lecturers to enhance their instructional skills. Finally, INTI-UC is committed to organising conferences and seminars that aim to promote the development of quality teaching skills. The International Conference on Teaching and Learning will be held on the 15th and 16th of November 2007 at Putrajaya Marriott Hotel.
Last but not least, we present to you the third video presentation that will showcase the research projects that are currently being carried out in INTI International University College.
Improving teaching by software crafting. Dr. Kwan San Ui, Faculty of Applied Science. Combating misconceptions among students can be done by crafting software using open source tools and leveraging various object-oriented frameworks such as Java and Microsoft.net. A novel approach to enhance growth and control reproductive performance of an economically important fish, the Oreochromis niloticus. Dr. Geeta Selvaraja, Faculty of Applied Science. The aims of the study are to identify the interrelationship between ghrelin, GHRH, kisspeptins, and GPR54, and to utilize ghrelin and kisspeptin to enhance growth and reproduction. Foreign Direct Investment, FDI, in ASEAN 5. before and after the financial crisis 1997. Song Kwok Tong, Faculty of Business and Accountancy. This research studies the importance of determinants of FDI and how they would affect the inflow of FDI in a particular country within ASEAN 5. Ecotourism product development in Malaysia. Sharifah Mastura binti Syed Abu Bakar, Faculty of Business and Accountancy. Understanding ecotourism markets, challenges and priorities for ecotourism product development and promotes ecotourism. In this context, the Malaysian government through Department of Environment, other relevant agencies and the non-governmental organizations has been conducting campaigns to raise the level of awareness on conservation issues throughout the country. Biomedical robotics. Gopalakrishnan Anand, Parasuram, Vigneswari Durairaja, Faculty of Engineering and Technology. Surgery and medical practice have improved by leaps and bounds over recent years with the help of biomedical engineering. Non-intrusive surgery has been made possible with engineering devices including robots. This research explores further the use of robotics in medical applications and develops an interdisciplinary design on special robots for these purposes. Transformative Learning in Engineering Education. Professor Dr. Nirwan Idrus, Ko Yit Yan, and Cho Cho Wing, Faculty of Engineering and Technology. The efficacy of learning through understanding and the ability to reconceptualize is evident in the learning outcomes achieved where such mode is used. Regrettably, such mode is not prevalent in Asian higher education system. Three pilot classes have been selected at INTI-UC to study this transformation with the aim of this mode being applied increasingly throughout the institution. The significant application deployment tools in the internet-based business, a quantitative investigation on MSC status corporations. Christina Chin, G. Kavita and Po Jiang Ling, Faculty of Computing and IT. This paper aims to investigate the present web development tools and programming languages adopted and highly utilized in the internet-based business industry. The findings will reveal the latest needs and expectations of web development skills and programming language proficiency levels that are a prerequisite for potential IT graduates to be employable in this industry. Dual Model Biometric System for Network Authentication. Sundraj Senthilkumar Kumar and Chandran Jayanti, Faculty of Computing and IT. In most network platforms, there are no regulations or controls to monitor or track security problems. The conventional method of using username and password is easy to remember but has many disadvantages. This paper proposes an alternative approach called Dual Model Biometric System, which uses a person's physiological and behavioral characteristics to decide whether the applicant is the one that he claims to be. Portfolios in the Language Classroom, the ICM Experience. Pawani Vijayaratnam, Faculty of Liberal Arts. This research concentrates on enhancing learner-centered practice through the use of portfolios. The key finding is on the importance of providing students with the opportunity for cross-fertilization between language learning and other content-based courses in order to bridge the gap between academic theory and social reality. Students and non-native speaker teachers' perception of native speaker, non-native speaker teachers teaching English in a private college, a pilot study. Judy M. Myung-Koon, Faculty of Liberal Arts. This research examines the insights and view of students and non-native speaker teachers on the different issues of native speaker and non-native speaker teachers teaching English in a private college in Malaysia. These touch on diverse teaching methods of the native speaker and the non-native speaker, preference of teachers and the like. Upcoming research project, year 2007, an exploratory study. An overview of the issues and challenges of the Nipah virus outbreak, a case of Bukit Blando and Sepang. This exploratory study aims to provide an overview on how the Nipah virus outbreak affected the community in Bukit Blando and Sepang, look at the changes in the economic activities, social and psychological state, and demographic structure of the community in Bukit Blando and Sepang after the Nipah virus outbreak, and to explore the potential areas of research for INTI-UC academicians. We see this research project as a service to the local community.
The time has arrived for the presentation of INTI International University College's grants and merit scholarships. Since 1991, INTI International University College, INTI College Subang Jaya and their partners have awarded scholarships worth 81 million ringgit to INTI students pursuing their degrees locally and overseas. This year alone, the total amount of scholarships in the form of tuition waivers worth 2.3 million ringgit was awarded to 381 students. Today, we have selected 16 students to represent all the scholarship recipients for the year 2007 to receive the scholarships from Yang Berhormat Datuk. We would like to invite Yang Berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, accompanied by Datuk Dr. Muhammad Zawawi and Professor Lee, to present INTI International University College's grant and merit scholarship to the worthy recipients. The recipients for the grant are Chong Jian from Sekolah Menengah Laki-Laki Methodist, Kuala Lumpur.
Lim Chiao Jian from Sekolah Menengah Convent, Batu Pahat. Once again, Lim Chiao Jian from Sekolah Menengah Convent, Batu Pahat.
Yap Jun Yik, Sekolah Menengah Taman Ehsan Kepong.
Ho Xiao Hun from Sekolah Menengah Jalan Kolam Air Batu Pahat.
Chan Moi Fan from Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan St. Anthony, Perak.
Pang Wen Lee from Sekolah Menengah Kenosian Convent, Segamat.
Pang Xiu Yi from Sekolah Menengah Kenosian Convent, Segamat.
recipients for the 100% tuition fee waiver are Ng Xin Yi from Sekolah Menengah Jenis Kebangsaan Hualien, Taiping with 12 A1s.
Chong Han Hong from Sekolah Menengah Ledang, Tangkak with 11 A1s.
Ho Chui Ling from Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Tinggi Port Dickson with 11 A's.
Nyoi Kai Liang from Sekolah Menengah Methodist Teluk Datuk, Banting with 11 A1s.
Wee Chen Hock from Sekolah Menengah Bandar Sunway with 11 A1s.
Tan Yon Hui from Sekolah Menengah Jalan Kolam Air, Batu Pahat with 11 A1s.
Tan Yong Jing from Sekolah Menengah Jenis Kebangsaan Jit Singh Bukit Mertajam with 11 A1s.
Gong Li Wan from Sekolah Menengah Agasi, Lahad Datu with 12 A's.
Last but not least, Ko Zijian with from Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Chun Ching Rawok with 12 A's. Recipients, will you please join Yang Berhormat Datuk for a group photograph?
Please give them another round of applause. Technologies. We are pleased to have Yang Berhormat Datuk Mustafa bin Muhammad, Minister of Higher Education Malaysia, as a witness to the exchange. We now welcome Professor John Duffield to join Professor Lee on the exchange, on the stage to exchange the MOA with Yang Berhormat as the witness. The MOA with the University of the West of England is for student exchange program as well as for internship in the UK, mainly for our business students. This may be later extended to the students of other disciplines. Thank you, Professor. Now, we would like to welcome Mr. Teo Chi Kiong to join Professor Lee on the stage to exchange the MOA with Yang Berhormat Dato' as the witness. The MOA with Agilent Technologies marks the collaboration between industry and academia. This collaboration covers, among others, joint research and development as well as the donation of 2.4 million ringgit worth of educational version licenses of ADS software by Agilent Technology to INTI International University College.
Thank you, Mr. Teo. Congratulations to the representatives of the University of the West of England, Bristol. Professor, we now invite Datuk Dr. Muhammad Zawawi to present a souvenir to Yang Berhormat Datuk Mustafa Muhammad.
What's that going to do to your relationship with your foreign partners?
The curriculum that we have for our own programs are under our own control. So we are able to design a curriculum that fits in with what the private sector in Malaysia wants. What the country wants, yes. And we are also able to put in the development of soft skills and internship. Some of these are not found in 3.0 programs.
And you save a lot of money. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Well, I mean, what difference will it make to the students, do you think?
Students will have slightly different experience. In one group, the students who are studying our own programs, they will have the additional advantage of having courses with soft skills embedded in the courses. Your second question, what will happen to the relationship, like what the Datuk Minister said just now, we will be able to continue to offer this for the next 10 years and gradually phase out these programs. But I think it's the Ministry's guideline that good programs can still be offered, provided they do not exceed a certain percentage. I think this is 20% of the total number of programs.
I mean, you have things like the Sunway Lancaster linkage. Is that a model that that maybe the minister thinks will take off? So Lancaster and Sunway now do in effect a joint degree, and the student gets the Lancaster scroll as well as the Sunway.
In the context of globalization. That's something that we encourage. We want our universities to collaborate with foreign universities, and that way you get yourself recognized, that way you get better known, and hopefully your degrees are marketable throughout the world. I mean, by linking up to Lancaster and Sunway, it is a joint degree. With that degree, hopefully you can work in the UK and Europe, in the European Union, and degree is good for employment in Malaysia as well. So going forward, this is something that we encourage, joint degrees.
You look at a higher level of relationship now, it's no longer kind of we are dependent.
That's right.
I think it's a higher interdependence rather than dependent.
And it's not a one, it used to be a one-way kind of. Right. Now it's mutual. Yeah. There are many things they can learn from us. It's not just us learning, it's not a one-way traffic.
In fact, we are actually exploring more innovative models rather than this is a straight jacket type of confinement. The Sunway, the Caster, you're fixed with one institution.
There's been many innovations in education. innovation is not only in manufacturing, in technology, education, there's been lots of innovation. 3+0 is an innovation by itself. And this joint degree issue program is an innovation part of Malaysian University. So I would encourage our private colleges and of course my public universities to be more and more innovative. Sorry.
Sekarang ni kan, Datuk, terlalu banyak private universiti. Adakah ia akan efek kepada quality of students yang akan keluar universiti?
Tak ada. Bilangan tak ada. Kita nak galak pelajar. Kita nak galak lebih ramai lagi rakyat Malaysia. Ada akses kepada tertiary education, dasar kerajaan. Yang penting kita tak mau mengorbankan quality. Quality is important, dasar kerajaan. At the same time, it cannot be at the expense of quality. Itu yang menjadi cabaran kita. That's why what is being done in INTI, umpamanya ada teacher training for lecturers, teknologi digunakan sepenuhnya untuk pembelajaran. Ini penting supaya quality. Yang penting adalah quality. Kita tak mau quality to be sacrificed at expense of quantity at expense of quality.
University colleges, once they're granted the status, they're given 10 years to come up with their own degrees, and then at the same time they can now continue to offer foreign degrees as well.
Yeah, apa itu? There's a certain academic percentage you have to check with. You check with him. There's a certain percentage. They are allowed to have a certain percent of foreign programs, but we encourage them to develop homegrown programs. Kita bagi from 5 to 10 years, kan?
Yeah, 5+5.
5+5.
Okay, so previously it was announced that once you start offering your own homegrown programs, you can no longer offer more.
There's been some relaxation, yeah. Okay. Bawa komponen dia, minimum pun. Apa itu foreign maximum pun. Ada, anyway you check with. Ada, mana? Mana Zita tu? You check, no, I don't have that. 20 akan menjadi 20. 20. Maximum. Maximum. Foreign.
That's a new thing, Datuk.
When
was that changed?
It's not new, it's been quite some time. We'll check. Azlan check je lah. We'll check lah. Yes? Hijau. Oh, itu. Relax je lah. Ini inti je. Tak apa.
Ada
perumahan
ya, Datuk?
Primary.
Ya? Nanti kita akan check kawan. Okey, lagi hal lain?
Tuk, tadi ada tengah hari punya berita TV3 ada kesedaran naik kelibatan pelajar
sebagai
JRO. Okey. JRO.
Pelajar JRO.
Kementerian mungkin ada terima
sama. Dia tak, apa itu, tidak situasi tidak itu, tidak membenarkan. Tidak boleh. Ya. Peraturan-peraturan tidak memenang pelajar. Pelajar PTS tak PTS?
Ya, dulu.
Ya. Tahap keseriusan, the level of seriousness of the offense. Itu sudah pada dalam universiti dan lembaga disiplin. The universiti will decide.
Dia efek dia punya pelajaran dia cepat dia lulus saja. Dia buat pengakuan dia hanya lulus saja. Patut sehari dia boleh dapat ribu lebih macam tu.
Yang pertama kita kena cemak lah kesahihan laporan sebut. Ya, yeah, we have to check.
Interview sendiri student
juga. Ya, kita kena cemak. Ya. Kadang-kadang dia menyamar. Ya. Dia jadi imposter dan menyamar. Ya. Yang penting kita kena cemak lah. Kesahihan sama ada tepat dan tidak. Dan kalau betul terbukti, maka kita serah di universiti untuk mengambil tindakan. Saya tak ada tindakan. Okay. Thank you.
Sorry, can I just ask one more question? I mean, I think the private sector was probably quite happy to hear the kind of things you were saying on the stage. Do you have any suggestions of the way in which maybe the private sector and the government universities, the IPTAs and IPTSs, could collaborate more?
We have started this process, but there are many gaps. It's not moving fast enough. And last year we had one meeting. The vice chancellors and the presidents of private colleges, we met. I chaired that meeting, and we're scheduling another meeting this year. but there are possibilities of research collaboration, staff training, for example, and going forward, even mobility, credit transfer. There are many possibilities, but it is a mindset. I think on the part of some people, this is totally new. Yeah? This is a new culture in Malaysia, and the biggest problem is changing people's mindset. But going forward, it is something that's got to be done. There are many among the private colleges, there are many good ones among them, and the possibilities of collaboration, I think, are huge. We started last year, and I hope we will gather momentum in the months ahead. Okay? Thank you. You enjoy yourself, yeah? Okay, you speak some Bahasa Malaysia.
Yeah.
This is your national set?
Yeah.
Are you from Nigeria? Quite a big number from. How many are from Nigeria? Yeah, in India. You stay on campus? You're from?
Saudi Arabia.
Have I seen you before? Have we met before?
From Sri Lanka?
Sri Lanka. Only two of you, Sri Lanka. Quite a few.
Actually, there are about
30
people there.
Where are the Sri Lankans mainly? Which university? The biggest number is it?
Biggest is Monash
and Sun. Monash?
From?
Nigeria. You're from? Malaysia, all of you. Well done. What was the show here? The name of the show here?
Saman.
Saman?
Yes.
The brother which?
Poches.
Poches. Poches. Thank you. Well done. You're from?
Kenya.
I was in Kenya 2 months ago. The best Kenya. Kenya. Nigeria. Myanmar. Thank you. Well done. Are you the only one from Angola? Okay. Angola, what language do you speak? You are Mozambique. And then from which part? Sudan. Any from Sudan?
Only encourage my friends to come.
Okay, you better encourage your friends to come. Many from China. Many from China. Are you in the three? Where are you studying?